don't have time to wait. If we don't do this now, the cops will come back. What are you trying to say? Something we don't know. What don't we know? But we just heard the guy's true feelings on TV! What didn't you understand? Well, what is it? I already told you there's no time to waste. Are you even getting at something here, or are you just stalling? Missing? Like what exactly? Damn it, I've heard enough of this bullshit. Give me a straight answer! Are we doing this or not? That's all I give a damn about right now.
He's right. Let's all calm down for a second.
I'm perfectly calm.
Hey, what did you mean by we're missing something?
What's there to miss with a sick bastard like him?
Hey, let's all take a deep breath. After what happened to Nanako-chan and seeing Dojima-san, we're not thinking straight right now.
Fine.
You're right. We should calm down and think rationally about this. I realize now that we've heard almost nothing from Namatame's perspective. There's no denying that this man brought great harm to Nanako-chan. But other than that point, the rest comes from our assumptions based on watching the Midnight Channel a moment ago. I won't deny that we were blinded by the heat of the moment, trying to impute all responsibility to him rashly.
But... yeah, the guy's not saying anything. Whatever reason he had, there's no doubt about the fact that he'd been throwing people inside the TV. It was him who put Senpai through that misery. How can we possibly understand someone who says killing people is the same as saving them?
Failing to understand and failing to listen are rather different things. Truthfully, not all the hitches that were nagging at me have been answered yet. We'll have to see what he can tell us about them. Though it appears he's in no condition to do so at the moment.
True. Dealing with him right now might not solve all the things that are bothering us. Damn it. But you better remember this. I'll do everything I can to stop him from repeating what he's done. Anytime, anywhere, anything. Jeez, how the hell can you stay so calm, man? Then again, that's why you're our leader. All right, let's go ahead and think this through as much as we need.
If we leave any unanswered questions behind, we'll just be lying to ourselves. Yeah, that ain't gonna cut it. All right, I'm convinced.
Thank you. I'll think as hard as I can and try to help.
We all know how you feel, Yosuke. Come on, we've accomplished this much together, haven't we?
Right. Together.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. Sorry. And thanks.
What are you doing? You can't be in here.
Oh, crap.
We were keeping an eye on the suspect. The police officers outside seem to have their hands full helping Dojima-san. If Namatame were to escape, it would be a disaster for the police's reputation. And their trust in you, Adachi-san.
Oh, I see. We'll tighten security from now on, and I'll arrange for him to be transported out as soon as possible. So, if you guys can keep quiet about being in here, I'd really appreciate it.
How is he, Doctor? He seemed to be extremely agitated a moment ago.
He seems fine for now, but he really needs his rest. Outside, everyone. Doctor's orders.
Understood.
We should go, too. Let's get back to Nanako-chan's room. So what's this thing we're missing, huh?
To tell the truth, there's something that's bothering me, too. Why did he start killing people in the first place?
Well, he said himself it was to save them, right? So he killed his lover in order to save her and kept going?
The police speculated the first murder was related to the affair, so they called in Namatame for questioning. But everything in his testimony and his bearing, no matter what they looked at, they found nothing suspicious. If he truly is twisted enough to believe that murder is a means of saving people, I think that would have shown through.
Maybe he faked it real well. Or maybe he started out with a normal motive and got a taste for killing after the first time.
No, if that were the case, his motive for killing that announcer would be even more inexplicable. Namatame and his wife were separated at the time. Both Misuzu Hiragi and himself testified that she had discarded him. Hiragi also knew about Yamano beforehand, and Namatame was shocked to hear of Yamano's death. Their relationship was known and was not strained to the point of murder. There's simply no motive in the affair angle. The police invested a great deal of effort into investigating this point. Therefore, we have no convincing motive for Namatame to kill Mayumi Yamano. Although, her name was written in Namatame's own diary.
This reason for killing her.
It's still possible that he was crazy to begin with and no one realized, right?
I don't really get any of this.
Ugh, this is so confusing!
Hey, we could hear you in there. This is a hospital. Maybe you should quiet down a little.
Oh, there you are, all of you.